Alright. Practice makes better, so let's keep it going. Here's another bike check on what is one of my favorite bikes ever from my favorite bike company, Crust Bikes. I have here the Lightning Bolt Canti, and this is a medium, also known as LB, also known as LBC, also known as Bolt, and this is considered their lightweight road PVP capable randonneuring bike, and it's one of the lightest frames in their lineup. And I'm extra proud of this build because it's the first bike I personally built up myself, minus the wheels, which came prefabricated from Crust. Let's start with the cockpit. Here I have the Crust Shaka Bar made by Nitto in 540 millimeters, wrapped in Brooks synthetic bar wrap. And I absolutely love these bars. I've ventured off and tried other handlebars, but I always come back to these. I also have the Nitto RM Dirt Drop, which are very similar and I really like as well, but the drop is a little shorter and a bit more flared, which I felt went better with my Crust Bombora. Also, the Shaka Bar is wider on the hood, so I felt it fit better with the Lightning Bolt because of the low trail, and the wider bars had the steering smooth like butter. For the shifters, I went with MicroShift 11-speed bar end shifters, and I can't say enough good things about them. No issues, no complaints whatsoever. I would actually go as far to say I enjoy changing gears on these than I do on anything else I have. I don't know why exactly, it's just so clean and precise and simple. For the brake levers, I went with TRP Retro in black and silver, and they're pulling on a set of PAW components cantilever brakes in polished silver. My Nitto NP stem is 70 millimeters, and I have my Midnight Caper packable jacket strapped onto it. For the headset, I hunted down a 1-inch Campy record, which was a lot harder to find at the time because no one had stock. Maybe a different case now. I have here a 2x48 and 30 tooth chain ring in black by White Industries, paired with White Industries ENO square taper cranks in 170. I put on an Ultegra front derailleur that I want to say I picked up on eBay, or I might have had it in my parts bin, along with the Ultegra rear derailleur that my buddy Anthony had in his parts bin. That's Anthony of Anthony's Bikes. You should check out his channel. He actually has a super sick romancer you should check out. And for the cassette, I put on an older 11x40 tooth XTR cassette that I had from 2015. On the other side here, I have the black Comalite from Blue Lug and the skewer from DT Swiss that I pulled from my parts bin as well. For the wheel set, I got the 650B rim brake wheel set from Crust in silver. And for the price, these are a no-brainer. They're light, strong, comes with the SP Dynamo hub with all the connectors already on. And I usually have it connected to a Sun E-Deluxe 2 bike light in black which works really good with the SP hub, but yeah, these are a no-brainer. For the tires, I currently have on there the Grand Boys Hetra, which are 42 millimeters in width, and they're made by Panaracer, and I have it set up tubeless. I've had 48 millimeters on there. I've had the Ultra Dynamic or Rose Kava mullet set up on there before for LA Invitational, and it felt really good. But I'm really liking these Grand Boys. They roll fast on tarmac, grippy enough for light gravel, and pretty much exactly what I use this bike for. On the handlebars, I have a Bagged by Bird Piccolo in large, and this is the black camo X-Pack. I also have a Goldback V2 in small, which I use on my saddle for bikepacking trips. But I love these bags. These are total game changers, especially for bikepacking. Lots of storage capacity, made super well. Shout out to Jay, he's the one-man team behind Bags by Bird. And I have the bag mounted on some middle struts that I attached onto a wood dowel with some middle clamp bands. Did this for additional support, but mainly because of the front brake cables. This kind of lifts it off it and it works great. I've had the bird tooth saddle I have on here for a few years now that I've moved on to, I think, three different bikes, and it's probably the most comfortable saddle that I own. This one here is the Erebus with titanium rails and with the cutout in the cork colorway, and it's aging really well. I have to admit, when I first got the saddle new with the splotchy leather pattern, I was a little annoyed just because it was so loud, but with just a few rides I knew it would look sick. I'm super happy the way it's aging. Under the saddle, I have on there the mini saddle bag by Outer Shell, and this is the black multicam. And of course I got the golden saddle triangle reflector made by Blue Luck. Some Nitto cable hangers, and the seat post I have on there is the Nitto SP92, and that's a size 27.2 with zero offset. The frame comes with this little rubber nipple on the inside of the head tube, and the Zafal HPX frame putt fits perfectly in there. This one here is a size 4. And I covered the logo up with some black electrical tape to keep it stealthy, but also you never know when you'll need some electrical tape. I think that pretty much sums up the build. Feel free to comment any questions at all, and thanks for watching. Peace.